so let's get into it. What are we doing today? Let's do some equations involving rational exponents. So in this case, what's a little bit different is that the base has got the x. So here's where we're kind of heading towards, is that we've got x to the power of something equals b to the c. So in other words, yeah, like x to the 3/4, x to the 2/3, you know, 2 to the power of x or 3 to the x or something like that. Okay, cool. So that's what we got. So we're going to raise and I'm going to work you through this one. So for example, 2 times x to the 3/4 equals 54. So our first step is just to recover from the ukulele, right? Okay. And go, okay, well, let's just write this as x to the 3/4 equals, divide both sides by 2 so that we've just got x to the something on the one side. Okay, equals 27. Now, here's where the magic comes in. And maybe I should have written this to give myself space for it. Equals 27. We want in our next line, so our next line is going to be here, we want to be x to the power of 1. So what can we raise x to the 3/4 to so that it becomes x to the 1? I don't know, I mean, it's quite a difficult concept, I guess, is if we raise that to the 4 over 3, we would raise a power to a power multiplier, so 3 over 4 times 4 over 3 gives us x to the 1. Well, I mean, that's x, right? That's what we want. What do we do on one side of the equation? Let's do on the other. 27 to the 4 over 3. Now, we should really do this using our exponents nicely. Of course, you've got your calculator on hand, but 27 is 3 cubed. So, raising a power to a power, we're going to multiply. So, 3 times 4 over 3. So, we're going to have 3 to the power of... What's 3 times 4 over 3? Well, it's just 3 to the 4, isn't it? Let's just check. 3 times 4 over 3. Well, over 1. 1 goes... 3 goes in there once. 1's 4 over 1. 4. Yeah, so... x equals 3 to the 4, which is 81, give or take, right? So our key part was getting it just x to the something and raising it to 4 over 3. Now remember, what's another way of writing x to the 3/4? How could we write that as a third? Well, it's x cubed, and then it's the 4th root. Okay. Now let's look at this one. X to the 2/3 equals 4. So just like as a mini aside, how could we write x to the 2/3 as a third? Well, it's x squared and then it's the cube root. So if x is a positive or negative number, we're going to get the same answer under the square root here, under the cube root. So let's see what I mean by that. X to the 2/3 equals 4. So in other words, x to the 2/3 equals 2 squared. Let's raise this to the power of something so that it becomes x to the 1. So what do we need to raise this to? Well, 3 over 2, kind of the inverse. So what do we do on one side? We do on the other, 3 over 2. So x equals, well, 2 times 3 over 2 gives us, which just gives us 3, so x equals 3. But, remember we said that x to the 2/3 means x squared cubed, cube rooted. So we're taking the cube root of 3 squared. But couldn't we as easily take the cube root of minus 3 squared? Because that's just going to give us 9, that's also 9. So we could have another solution, or x equals minus 3. So if this is an even number, the numerator, it means that we're kind of squaring it, or to the 4th power, 6th power, and I was way in the way of all of that. So if that's the case, then let's move me a little bit along here. So if that's the case, then we're going to have two solutions. And it's because, remember, as I said, x to the 2/3 means x squared and then the cube root of that. So it doesn't matter if x was positive or negative, we're going to get a positive number underneath this radical, underneath this root sign. Okay, so let's do one more. Ooh, where are we at? X to the minus 2/3 equals 16. So as far as possible, let's kind of avoid just going, oh, we'll use our calculator. So 2 to the 4 is 16. We can raise this to what such that our next line is x to the power of 1? We'll buy minus 3 over 2, because minus 3 over 2 times minus 2 over 3 gives us 1. What do we do on one side? We do on the other. Okay, we're multiplying 4 times minus 3 over 2. 4 times minus 3 over 2. 1, 2 goes in there once, 2 goes in there twice. 2 times 3 is 6, equals 2 to the minus 6. Okay, but remember, this 2 over 3 means that we're squaring and then cube rooting. So that's one option. Or x could be minus 2 to the minus 6. So if we were to simplify this, 1 over 2 to the 6, or x equals minus 1 over 2 to the 6. So 1 over 64, I think it is. Okay, so two solutions. So that's the only real thing to kind of look out for, is if we've got an even numerator in the exponent. Sure, I'm not doing well. I'm covering things up here. Okay, so that's that. Not too bad, right? Time for some more ukulele, I think. Ding, 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 ding. Oh, here it is, here. Right. What do you think? Goodbye.